Today, we'll learn how to quickly calculate the integration of fractions using the box rule without use substitution through the examples here. If you watch this video until the end, you'll be able to solve this complex-looking problem in just one or two lines. Let's first learn about the box rule for fractions. When integrating a fraction and the numerator looks like the derivative of the denominator, then the answer will be ln box plus c. The first example is simple. Since the problem has a fraction, we check if the derivative of the denominator matches the numerator. The derivative of the denominator is negative 2x, but the numerator only has x. Even though they are different by the factor of negative 2, the constant factor is not a problem. We put 2 minus x squared in the green box and negative 2x, which is the derivative of the green box, in the numerator. However, we cannot simply multiply by negative 2. So we divide it by negative 2 in front of the integration. You know, multiplying negative 2 divided by negative 2 does not change the equation at all. Now, let's fill the blank on the right. We multiply by negative half and put 2 minus x squared in the green box on the right, which is the same as the green box on the left. This will be the answer. Look at this example. If we differentiate e to the power of x minus e to the power of negative x in the denominator, what do we get? That's right. We get e to the power of x plus e to the power of negative x, which is located in the numerator. So, we can put e to the power of x minus e to the power of negative x in the green box, and e to the power of x plus e to the power of negative x in the box prime. We can also put e to the power of x minus e to the power of negative x, which is the same as the green box on the left, in the right-hand green box. This gives us the answer. In this problem, the numerator is simply 1, and the denominator contains both tangent x and cosine square x. Let's try moving cosine square x from the denominator to the numerator. As the reciprocal of the cosine x is secant x, so the numerator becomes secant square x. Now, let's apply the box rule and fill in the boxes. We can put tangent x in the green box, and its derivative, which is secant square x, in the box prime. Finally, we can put tangent x alone in the right-hand green box to complete the calculation. Let's take a break and solve an easier problem. Tangent x is equal to sine x over cosine x, and when we differentiate cosine x in the denominator, we get minus sine x. Let's put cosine x in the green box and its derivative, which is negative sine x, in the box prime. But wait, can we just multiply a minus sign as we please? No, we need to multiply another minus sign out of the integral to ensure that the signs are all correct. We can multiply by negative 1 and put cosine x along the right-hand green box. And move on to the next problem. This problem also has all the terms in the denominator. To create the box prime over the box that we want, let's move x from the denominator to the numerator. If we multiply 1 over x to the top and the bottom, x in the denominator disappears, and the only 1 over x remains in the numerator. Well done, it has been successfully moved. What was the derivative of ln x again? Yes, it was 1 over x. Now let's apply the box rule by putting ln x in the denominator and 1 over x in the numerator, and ln x in the right-hand box as well. And we are done. Here is the problem we introduced earlier. It looks very complicated, doesn't it? Let's take it apart step by step. First, let's move the x in the denominator to the numerator by multiplying both top and the bottom by 1 over x as we did before. Let's look at the denominator now. The derivative of ln x squared is 2 times ln x times 1 over x, which we can solve directly using the box rule of differentiation without chain rule. I will explain the box rule for differentiation in another video later. Anyway, the term we just differentiated is in the numerator. Now, it's time to use our box rule. We can now put 1 plus ln x squared in both the left and the right green boxes and put 2 ln x times 1 over x in the box prime located in the numerator. Wow, all done in 2 lines. Here's a bonus question. This is a problem that some of my students often make mistakes on. You should not use the box rule for fractions because the derivative of square root x squared plus 3 is significantly different from the 2x in the numerator. So what should we do? How about bringing the square root term to the numerator? And it becomes 2x times x squared plus 3 to the power of negative half, and this problem becomes a basic box rule problem. If you don't know much about the basic box rule or want to know more, please click the link in the upper right corner. Now, let's fill in the boxes. Put x squared plus x in the green box makes the exponent negative half and put 2x in the box prime. Then put the same term x squared plus 3 in the right green box and add 1 to the exponent to make it negative half plus 1 and divide it the same way. The answer is x squared plus 3 to the power of half over half. And to simplify it, multiply by 2, both top and the bottom to get the answer of 2 times x squared plus 3 to the power of half plus c. We have learned how to use the box rule in fractions. More videos on the box rule will be uploaded in the future. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. And I will come back with more helpful videos for you next time. This has been your Math Guardian Alex. Thanks for watching.